now and then, I like to go through some real special cards that I've received, that I've saved, letters, and it just really touched my heart. All right, I'm going to look at one that I've saved for many, many years. Very special letter. For the bride and groom. I must have kept this long for some reason. I keep going back to it. June 17th, 1975. Holy moly. Dear Barbara and Fred, in about 4 more days, you'll be man and wife. It's a big day for both of you and your families. Unfortunately, Pat and I will not be able to make it as much as we would like to. Yeah, Pat is my cousin who has brain cancer. Pat has been pretty sick for the past 3 weeks, and just today left the hospital after a 10-day stay. Oh. She will have to stay in bed and get lots of rest for a while. And we're very happy that we'll be able to see you too when we can come down again. You'll be in our thoughts all day. And of course, we wish you all the happiness possible. While Pat was in the hospital, I had much time to think about our married life. There have been times in the past year and 1/2 when we could have lost Pat. And she still is not out of the woods yet. So for what it is worth, I thought I'd jot down a few words about marriage and about your spouse and your relationship together. If you feel it's kind of corny and not apropos, bear with it for a few lines. All right, I'm here. We've been married almost 19 years, and there have been many building blocks on which our lives have been based. At times, these blocks have fallen or been weak, but most have been sturdy. There have been many good memories and events and a few bad ones. The latter we forget easily, for they aren't worth remembering. The good times are not just going out on the town or having a wild fling at Tahoe. The good times include making breakfast for the evening, saying goodbye in the morning, or being at the airport when we return from a trip. They include a smile or a frown, sharing a joke, a private joke, just looking at each other or just knowing the other is in the house. It's raising a family, paying bills, wondering how we can pay for the orthodontist, labor, soothing our children's aches and pains, and enjoying awards giving them, going to the PTA or scout meetings, and seeing each other's families, or just being alone together. Many times, married people take each other for granted. We half listen to the other, or sometimes ignore needs. We know the other is there, so we go about our business. We argue about seemingly important things and at times magnify faults. And a few days later, we forget why we disagreed. That was a long letter. Oh, heart. Again, while Pat was in the hospital, and when I've been told that she might not live, I relived our married life.
I find I've been quietly, I've been guilty of many oversights and too much taking Pat for granted. Okay. Wow. No wonder I kept this letter for so long. After consideration, I might be too hard on myself. Yet there still remains too many instances where I could have been a better husband. And at this time, when you're getting ready to start your lives together, let me just give you a few thoughts to you. Respect one another, thoughts and actions. Remember, each of you is human. Talk and listen to each other, always. Forget the count. Give in first, blow off steam, but go to sleep in harmony. Always remember that we, oh, I know what this means. Always remember that we hang on to life by a thread, and it's very precious. Oh, our best to both of you, and while we're not there, to wish you well, you'll be in our thoughts. Love, Bill and Pat Drury, my dear cousins. Oh my gosh, I've kept that letter for, let's see, 75, 85, 95, 2005. Oh my gosh, 2015 is 40 years I've been married. I got married when I was 10. Oh, we've been through so much together, Fred and I. Travels and health and sickness and joy and sorrow, and it's all